I don't agree. I think the U.S. The U.S. manner of doing business lies at the root of all the trouble. You know, if it hadn't been for Goldman Sachs and their little minions running around in Athens, telling Greece how they could hide their losses in special purpose vehicles and then apply to the EU for membership, we might not have this problem today because Greece might not have ever become a member of the European Union. So, I mean, you know, Americans' business ethics, business practices, I think, are largely responsible for the trouble, but not the dollar itself. The dollar is, for better or for worse, the international currency of reference.
And it wouldn't change for the foreseeable future.
All right.
And it wouldn't change as a reserve currency, essentially, is what...
No, not yet. No, there's no other currency that can carry the mantle of the dollar. You know, they're just not big enough. They don't have what it takes. Now, the euro might have had in the past, but it's really looking very shaky, more and more shaky by the day. So I don't really think that... as yet, there is a replacement.
Not the yuan, not anything like that. Okay.
No, not anything else. Let's go on to the gold question, Bill.
Okay.
The gold question now was whether the European Central Bank, by calling upon Germany's gold, is giving value to gold as money.
Exactly.
The answer is no, I don't think that's the case. I think basically they... looked at Germany, saw that Germany was not prepared to give up their financial assets to the cause of keeping the southern European economies alive, and therefore they decided that they would try for the gold. I mean, it's absurd. It's as absurd as going to China, cap in hand, and saying, China, we know you're terribly poor, we know your people earn less than 10 cents an hour, but we'd be awfully happy if you could put your international reserves into the European southern countries and see if we can, you know, make them go full speed ahead. Sorry to have to, you know, ask you that, but we really don't have a choice right now. I mean, they're mad. I mean, the truth is that these poor Europeans have bitten off much more than they could chew with this huge economic bloc, which cannot possibly work given the disparity in cultures and economic fortunes of the different countries. And so here they are, you know, furiously beating around, looking for money wherever they can get it, and it's not going to happen. And it's pathetic and sad to watch them, you know, debase themselves in this way. In the Great Depression, it doesn't count, because gold was fixed to the dollar at a price of $20 an ounce, and then as soon as Roosevelt arrived, he first of all told every American that they had to hand in all their gold to the nearest Federal Reserve Bank, and then just after that, he put the price of gold up to $35 an ounce. So thank you very much, Roosevelt. He robbed the country of its wealth. Nobody ever talks about that. Nobody ever
discusses
how outrageous and iniquitous that was, but that's what he did. So it would be really useful, I think, if a few people got to grips with that. But, of course, it did mean that gold itself was of no particular value in terms of speculation because it couldn't move in price. However, Bill, what did move in price was gold stocks. Because since everything else was falling in value because of the Depression, the only thing that people felt had value for the future was gold mines and gold mining companies.
So they bid
up the price of these stocks in the absence of anything else to basically bid up, and so they went to fabulous prices in very short order. Now, that's not going to happen this time because the price of gold and gold stocks is a free market function. And therefore, everything that you see is everything you get, basically. And there's no real evidence that people are going to see gold stocks in the same light as they did in the days when they were sure that gold couldn't fall in value. And therefore, gold mines gained in value through a process of speculation. Not going to happen this time around, I'm afraid. And I think that gold will fall in value. It fell $50 plus yesterday alone. Today it's up slightly, up $3 as against a fall of $50 yesterday. I think a lot of people who have gold are going to be horribly hurt in the months to come. That's my personal view, Bill. Take it or leave it. That's how I feel about gold.